It's a blue world, alone. Good morning, Aztecs. It's October 14th, 2022. This is our first news broadcast for the month of October. Today is Be Bald and Be Free Day. We're your hosts, Kale
and Michael. Let's get into the news. Homecoming was last Saturday, the 8th of October. We hope you had a great time celebrating our football team's win at the homecoming game. A huge thank you to our ASB class for organizing this great event.
Wednesday was College Door Day at PDHS. Teachers could decorate their classroom doors to show spirit for a college or university of their choice. Prizes were available for the doors with the best school spirit. Great job to all the teachers who participated.
Next Wednesday, the Feminism in Action Club will be hosting a peaceful protest in the front parking lot of the PDHS campus. Students interested in protesting against the current dress code are asked to meet there at 8:45 in the morning before school starts. You can find additional information or updates on future events on the FIA Club's Instagram page.
Now, here's Lane 40 with this week's Aztec Sports News.
Hey Aztecs, I'm Lane 40 and I'm back with another week full of Aztec sports updates. There's a lot happening on campus this week as all of our fall sports are in full swing, so let's just jump right into the action. Our Lady Golf team faced Laquita Monday night and of course took the W. Our ladies will hit the links two more times this week, the first of which on Wednesday against Shadow Hills and on Thursday against Xavier. Our Lady Tennis team only has two matches this week, the first of which is on Tuesday at Rancho Mirage, and on Thursday they're home against La Quinta. Only two matches for our volleyball team this week, both of which are away, the first of which on Tuesday is at Shadow Hills, and on Thursday they're at Palm Springs. There is cross-country action this week as well. BL prelims are on Wednesday at Xavier, so good luck to all our runners. In water polo action, it is jam-packed, a lot going on. On Tuesday, they will face off against Rancho Mirage on the road. On Wednesday, they play Indio at home, and on Thursday, they face off against Servite, also on the road. And lastly, in boys varsity football action, our guys will take on Rancho Mirage on the road as well. This Friday night, this game will have major DEL implications, so make sure to come out and support. Well, Aztecs, that's all I have this time. Make sure to tune back in next week for another update of all things Aztec sports. I'm Lane 40, and I'll see you soon.
Thanks, Lane. In other news, congratulations to Logan Stendel and Valeria Arauz for winning first and second place, respectively, in the Fountains at Carlotta Retirement Village Door to the Future contest. They received their awards last Saturday, and we could not be more proud. Way to go, Aztecs.
Joining us on today's broadcast is Elise Pardue, the president and founder of the Feminism in Action Club, who will be sharing information on the current events in Iran.
On September 13th, a 22-year-old Kurdish woman named Mahsa Jina Amini was arrested in Tehran by the morality police because she was not wearing her state-mandated hijab properly. She was thrown into a police van because of a few strands of hair. In said police van, she was beaten en route to a re-education center by Iranian officers. When Amini arrived at the re-education center, she fell into a coma. 3 days later, on September 16th, she was pronounced dead. Her death has caused outrage across Iran and among the Iranian diasporic community. While Iranians are protesting for the right to choose to wear the hijab, the government is silencing them, arresting them, killing them, and kidnapping protesters. Approximately 185 people have died, and this number is rising. Recently, Nika Shakarimi was kidnapped, raped, and beaten to death by Iranian security forces. The Iranian police did not even have the decency to let Shakarimi's family bury their 16-year-old daughter. The police buried her in a village far from her family. These people are unjust. When regarding the situation, it's important to remember that these protests are occurring because the Iranians want freedom. They are not protesting Islam. They are protesting the overbearing government that systemically murders women on a basis of religious justification. We, the FIA, want to continue to amplify the voices of Iran and the barbaric actions of the Iranian government. Big news agencies have not stepped up in covering the past month in Iran. This is the biggest women's rights protest of the decade, and there needs to be more coverage. Lack of coverage will give the Islamic Republic more power, and that cannot happen. The Iranian people deserve freedom, and the first step to helping them is talking about these protests. To further support the cause, you can donate at iawfoundation.org.
This is the first one I've ever been to. A bit having fun, hanging out with friends. everyone's having fun. I think everyone is more involved than it's ever been, so it's been great.
That's all we have for you this week. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.